Good morning students, let's start today exercise 1.1 question number 6. Multiply 6 upon 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16. See, multiply 6 by 6 upon 13 by the reciprocal of 7 minus 7 upon 16. So let's find the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16. Okay, so what I will write here, reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16 is equal to, what is the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16? 16 upon minus 7. 16 upon minus 7. What is the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16? 16 upon minus 7. Now what we can do? See, this minus sign is for denominator. We can transfer it for the numerator. See, this sign we can transfer to the numerator. Okay, previous year we have learned these all the things. So what it will get? Minus 16 upon 7. So what we got? The reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16, minus 16 upon 7. Okay, what is the question? Given question is multiply 6 upon 13. Multiply 6 upon 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16. Reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16 is minus 16 upon 7. Okay, what we got? Minus 16 upon 7. 16 are 96. 16 are 96. See here, so I write here 96. See, this is positive number and this is negative. So their product will be the negative. 13 are 19. 13 are 91. So what is the answer? Minus 96 upon 91. Okay. Let's see question number 7. Tell what property allows you to compute 1 upon 3 multiplied by into bracket 6 into 4 upon 3 as, see now, in bracket 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 into 4 upon 3. Now if you will observe this example, see the numbers are same, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3, 6 multiplied by 6, 6 multiplied by 4 upon 3, 4 upon 3. Only grouping is different. Only grouping has done different. See, I will show you 1 upon 3 into bracket 6 into 4 upon 3 as, it is given as 1 upon 3 into 6 into 4 upon 3. Now see here, only it has formed the group differently. See, 1 upon 3. So 1 upon 3 into, now first we will solve the bracket. See here, we can do the lowest term here, only 3 1 that 3, 3 to the 6. Okay, so 2 4s are 8. What we got here? 8. 8 1s are 8. 8 upon 3 I got. Okay, now I will solve this also. First we will solve this bracket. Okay, so 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. 2 we got here. See, 2 into 4 upon 3. Now 2 4s are 8. 8 upon 3 means both of them we have got the equal. Means even we change, the grouping, answer remains the same. So which property has used in these? Associativity property. Which property? See, tell what property allows you to compute these as 1 upon 3 into bracket 6 into 4 upon 3 as 1 into bracket 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 bracket completed into 4 upon 3. Means even you change the grouping, answer remains same. So which property here? Associativity property. So what is your answer? Associativity property. Okay, which property? Associativity property. So question number 8 is 8 upon 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 integer 1 upon now. That we have to write here. Okay, so let's find first improper fraction for this number. Okay, so minus 1 integer 1 upon 8. We have to find the improper fraction for this. Now, how to write 8 multiplied by minus 1? 8 into 1, 8. 8 into 1, 8. Okay, so 8 is positive. 1 is, this 1 is negative. So their product will be the negative 8 into minus 1 minus 8. Plus 1 we have to add in this denominator as it is. See, this number, it is same. How we are doing the improper fraction for simple mixed fraction? Same way. See, suppose the number is given 1 integer 1 upon 8. What you are doing? 8 into 1, 8 plus 1 upon 8. 7 is 9 upon 8, you will get the answer. But here it is negative. So we have to write here 8 into minus 1. See, 8 into minus 1. One number is positive, another number is negative. So their product will be the negative, so minus 8. And this numerator we have to add in. See, here also it is added. So here also add. Okay. So what we got the answer for this? Minus 8 plus 1. Minus plus minus. So subtract 1 from 8. What you will get? 7. For answer, negative sign. So minus 7 upon 8 we got. Okay. Now what we have to find is 8 upon 9, the multiplicative inverse of these. See, we have found the improper fraction for this. See, for this number, improper fraction is minus 7 upon 8. So, what it is asked is, this number is multiplicative inverse of this number. Now, what is multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse is the number. If we will multiply two numbers, that product should be the 1. See, suppose if I have written 2 upon 3. Multiplied by 3 upon 2. I multiply this number. See, 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2. So their product we got 1. See, this number I have written, I did the reciprocal of this number 2 upon 3. What is the reciprocal of that number 3 upon 2? So at last we got the product 1. So what is the multiplicative inverse understood? Multiplicative inverse, this product should be the 1. See, here I am writing multiplicative inverse means if you will do the product of that both the numbers, it should be the 1. Multiplicative inverse means product should be the 2 numbers, that product should be the 1. Okay. Now see here, if what it is asked in the question is 8 upon 9 the multiplicative inverse of this number. What we have to find? This number is, this number is multiplicative inverse of this number. Okay. So let's write this number 8 upon 9 and let's write this number. Now this number I have written in the form of fraction. Okay. So that is minus 7 upon 8. What is multiplicative inverse? Product should be 1. Now this both the numbers product will see whether we are getting 1 or not. Okay. Now 8 upon 9 multiplied by minus 7 upon 8. 8 upon 9 into minus 7 upon 8. Now let's do the reduce term. For to show the reduce term, I have written again this step term. 8 ones are 8, 8 ones are 8. 1 into minus 7, minus 7. 9 into 1, 9. So what you got answer here? Minus 7 upon 9. And what is multiplicative inverse? Product should be the 1. This product should be the 1. But we got minus 7 upon 9. That is not equal to 1. This product we didn't get equal to 1. So 8 upon 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 integer 1 upon 8. So what you will write here? Therefore, 8 upon 9 The multiplicative inverse of minus 1 integer 1 upon 8. Okay, so 8 upon 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 integer 1 upon 8.
Which is not defined.
Okay, so the rational number does not have a reciprocal, which is that rational number 0. 0 is the rational number, it does not have the reciprocal. See, if you will do the reciprocal of 0, it comes 1 upon 0, and that is not defined. 1 upon 0. 1 upon 0. What is rational number? We have to write the number in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0. It is not defined, so we cannot divide by 0. We can divide to 0, but we cannot divide by 0. Okay, so 0. Why 0? 0 is the rational number, everyone knows, because it has the denominator 1. So this is rational number, and we have to find the rational number that does not have the reciprocal. Reciprocal of 0 is 1 upon 0, which is not defined. Means, which is the rational number? It does not have the reciprocal. 0 is the rational number, it does not have the reciprocal. Remaining all the numbers have the reciprocal. Okay. So now let's solve next question. Now the rational numbers that are equal to their reciprocals. Which are the rational numbers that are equal to their reciprocal? Now if you will see 1 and minus 1, these are the two numbers which are that number 1 and minus 1. These are the numbers. 1 and minus 1, these are the numbers, these are the rational numbers that are equal to their reciprocals. If you will see, reciprocal of 1, these are the two numbers. These are the two rational numbers that are equal to their reciprocal. If you will do the reciprocal of 1, okay. So, reciprocal of 1. Reciprocal of 1. See, 1 means 1 upon 1. 1 upon 1. And what is the reciprocal of 1 upon 1? Reciprocal of 1 upon 1 again remains the same. See, 1. Reciprocal of 1. See, here there is no reciprocal of 1 we have to find. Here there is no denominator, means 1. So if you will find the reciprocal, reciprocal means what we are doing? 1. The numerator plus we are writing this denominator, and denominator plus we are writing this numerator. So 1 upon 1, which is equal to 1. So reciprocal of 1 is equal to, now 1 upon 1 is equal to 1, means what it is as the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal. So 1 is the number, 1 is the rational number, it is equal to its reciprocal. If you will do the reciprocal of 1, you are going to get the answer 1. Right now I have explained you. Okay, now we will see for the minus 1. Reciprocal of minus 1. Reciprocal of minus 1. Now see, reciprocal of minus 1.